So let's talk about validation and verification of AI systems. Why is this so important, John?
Validation and verification is becoming much more important. It's important in all systems. So, and lately we have seen a lot of regulation forcing verification of anything with security importance. So validation, that's that you ensure that it fulfills the customer's needs that you need to do with the customer. Verification is that you verify that it fulfills requirements, specifications, regulations, and so on. And then you can make a third party do it, and it becomes certification. Yeah. And one reason you do to lower risk and liability. We have seen a lot of regulation in 5G, IoT, drones, and I would suspect that there will be forced verification in AI systems also.
And how are system elements containing AI supposed to be treated?
I think you need to include them in the same progress that you have your normal software systems, but AI is a bit tricky, but in general, we need to change the system so it fits AI also. One aspect with AI is that you have the input data also that you also need to verify. It's not just the AI model, it's the data. And then very recent regulation is supply chain security. So you need to trust your supplier, and then you need to verify transfer, and that it you keep the same AI model when it's operating.
You say it's tricky. If you compare with verifying traditional software, validating and verifying traditional software systems, what's the big difference? Just so we understand.
One difference is that for traditional systems, it's easier to make like a input-output correct answers. For example, if you have a mathematical equation, that's trivial. For AI system, that's much harder. And sometimes what the right answer is a bit fluffy. It doesn't have a right answer.
Why is that?
Why is that? Some humans need to define what the right answer is, and that's very hard. It's like you show the AI some fluffy picture. Is this something that's in the middle? Then it's like... it's not mathematical. There's no mathematical answer there. Then you have one thing is that is tricky with verification is that some AI systems continue to learn when they are deployed. And then you have...
You get so excited, you lose your microphone.
Yeah. And then you verify something when you first deploy it, and then it continues learning. So the system evolves. Then it's not the same system anymore. So what you verified is no longer in use.
Maybe we can have a hand microphone for John. I don't know.
So I can...
What else is different compared to traditional software systems?
Some software systems can be like 100% accurate that you typically don't get from an AI system. And then also AI systems are... Many AI systems are probabilistic. So they like... they use. You get a little bit different answer each time you ask. While many traditional software are deterministic, you get the same answer. Yeah.
And how do you address the ethical implication and potential biases associated with AI algorithms during verification and validation?
Maybe that's a more general question than validation, verification. One thing is that you might have to verify the data. So AI, you have a data model and you have data, and then you train it, and then you get the AI system that you deploy. So you might need to verify the data before also. And also the data, if you want to reduce bias, you should probably start with the data. Bias you can probably test in the final algorithm. Ethics you cannot really test. It's in the eye of the beholder. But for your AI system, you should probably try to formulate what your ethical guidelines are, and then try to apply that. But that's a hard, that's a hard, something that's hard to do, to both formally and what your ethical guidelines are and how to test it.
Have you been involved in any practical examples that you could share with us on validating and secure verification of an AI system, and just give us some ideas of how different is the procedure? Were there additional steps?
Haven't personally been deploying anything, but it's what I said before. It's complicated to much more complex to test things. Also, if it continues to evolve, it's also with the software you have version 0.0, and then maybe some year later you deploy the next version, and then you have tested that also. But if you have AI systems that continuously learn, then it's very hard to verify. Then you have a different system each day or after each input.
So will we have a solution? Or how do you think we will actually address this issue?
I think we need more research. And then maybe we need to... I think today you should... Maybe you cannot deploy AI systems in some cases. AI systems react... Today they work very good when they get good data. Nobody tries to trick them. But as soon as there is some attacker that can supply the data, either the training data or data when they're operational, they behave very badly. And they're like... You can have fooled them in very surprising ways.
So yeah, we have seen attacks where you sort of surprise the AI. What are the consequences?
Yeah, so some of these attacks are that you can, for example, take a picture of something and then modify it in a very specific way. So to a human, the picture looks exactly the same, but the AI is very confident that it's something completely different. Instead of a cat, the AI thinks to all humans it looks like a cat, but the AI is super sure it's a dog. It's very surprising, and you can do this also in reality, like you can place some stickers on the stop sign to make a self-driving car thinks it's like a speed limit instead. And there are more things like that. For example, a breakthrough for AI system was this computer playing Go. And now it was attack on the Go playing system. You can fool it by basically making a circle around it, like a very stupid... you could never win against an AI, a human player like that, but most AI systems are fooled. I think consequence is probably that AI systems are not very intelligent. Intelligent is maybe... they're very powerful, but they're not... intelligent in the way we mean for humans.
And they're not
humans.
Conscious of the context.
No, you can easily trick them in a very surprising way, and you cannot really, it doesn't help to let a human check the input either, because it can really look like a cat and then turns out something very different. So I think consequences probably you should be a bit careful for when you use AI. You need to control the input data when you train, and then you need to be able to control the input data when it's operating, at least if you want to use it where it matters for safety or security.
For your research group, what would you like to spend a lot more time on? You say there's so much more research we need to do, and we can clearly hear that this is an area that will become increasingly important, and we need to verify and validate.
I think many areas of AI and cybersecurity needs more research. I think one thing is the overall, how do you design, how do you create secure systems and make them operations and operate them securely? Then I think we need to find How do we stop this, like data poisoning attacks and adversarial attacks where you trick the AI with wrong data? I think we need more transparency so you can find out how was the AI trained and also...
the model itself.
Yeah, and more explanation. Today, that's an ethical problem also. Today you can often, even if the AI takes very good decisions, you can often not explain why it took this decision, which might be concerning to a lot of humans. And then I think exciting area is how to use AI for to do attacks. We had an interesting side channel attack published recently from Elena Dubrova and KDH, how you use AI to perform attacks. I think
we can learn a lot from that.
Yeah, to be able to protect against attacks, we need to understand what kind of attacks you can do. Yeah.
Ending on attacks. Thank you, John, for joining
Thank
us
you.
Today. Thank you.